next time.
In the previous part, in this experiment, resistance of galvanometer by Kelvin's method, we have considered aim, apparatus, formula, as well as the circuit diagram. Now, let us consider how to make the connections. This is a Wheatstone's meter bridge. Here, this red is a positive terminal and this green is a negative terminal. Let us start with this wire, which is from positive terminal, which is connected to the resistance box. Then the wire from resistance box is connected to the meter bridge. Here, this is a left gap. Then the wire is taken from this particular point B. This is the point A, this is the point B, where the jockey or a sliding key is connected. Next, in this gap, that is a right gap, a galvanometer is connected. This terminal is connected to the positive terminal of galvanometer. Then the second wire is connected to the negative terminal of galvanometer. Here, the another terminal is connected to the rheostat, variable of rheostat, and the base of rheostat is connected to negative terminal of a cell, a battery cell, a cell having 5 volt of AMF, and positive terminal of the cell is connected to the point A. Here, this wire is having a length of 1 meter. You can consider the distance from here 0, 1, 2, 3 up to 100. Here, this is a wire having 1 meter or 100 centimeter. After making the connections, let us see how to perform the experiment. Here, rheostat is adjusted at a certain position. Then, from this resistance box, you have to take out a certain resistance. Now, this key is taken out having a resistance of 50 ohm from the resistance box. 50 ohm is taken out. This is a suitable resistance. Why I have taken out 50 ohm? Because the resistance of galvanometer I have assumed to be around 50 ohm. Therefore, I have taken 50 ohm from the resistance box. Now, if you observe the deflection in the galvanometer, as soon as the current is switched on, you are getting a deflection around 20 divisions in the galvanometer. Now, without touching the jockey, the galvanometer is showing the deflection because it is directly in the electrical circuit. Now, touch the jockey at the point A and observe the deflection in the galvanometer. It is towards right side of the 20. Now, touch the jockey at the point this. You are getting the deflection towards left. That means we are getting the deflections on opposite sides at the point A and at the point C. Therefore, we are getting a point D here. Let us check out the position of point D here. Here you are observing that there is no deflection in the galvanometer. The pointer will be at the same position with and without touching the jockey. Without touching, it is showing some deflection, and when we touch here, then also there is no deflection in the galvanometer. This point is called, is not called a null point, but it is called a balance point. I am getting a deflection around 46 here. So this is a galvanometer. The length in front of galvanometer is LG and the length in front of resistance box is LR. In this case, LR we are counting from this 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 46. So 46 is the value of LR and 54 is the value of LG. So I have to record these observations in the observation table. The value of R is 50 ohm, the value of LG is 54 and the value of LR is 46. This is your first observation. Then you have to change the value of R. Instead of 50, now I am taking 10 ohm resistance from the resistance box. So now this will be 50 plus 10, that is 60 ohm I have taken out from the resistance box. Now the deflection in the galvanometer will change, but don't observe the deflection in the galvanometer. Again, touch the jockey at the point A, it is towards left. Now at the point C, it is in the opposite direction, deflection in the opposite direction, that means our connections are correct. Now again find out the position of point D here, where the pointer is showing zero deflection. Zero means the pointer is at a certain position, say 22, again it will show 22, that means there is no deflection in the galvanometer. Now here this is a point D, say 51 is the value of LR and 49 is the value of LG in this case. Again you have to take one more reading by changing the value of capital R, the resistance box. First reading we are taken for 50, then 60, now I am taking the value of R as 70, 50 plus 20, that is 70, and I am now observing whether I am getting the deflection on both the sides by touching the jockey at A and B. Yes, we are getting it. Now find out again the position of point D, whatever is its value, just record it the value of LG and LR in this case. Again you have to repeat the experiment by interchanging the positions of resistance box and galvanometer. This galvanometer is connected in the left gap and resistance box is connected in the right gap. Again you have to repeat the experiment by changing the values of R, that is 50, 60 and 70. So you will get the values of LG and LR, corresponding values, and you can calculate the resistance of galvanometer using the formula Z is equal to R into LG upon LR, and finally find out the mean value of Z, which will be the resistance of a galvanometer using Wheatstone meter bridge.